Well, Simple Lab did tell me that the most accurate way to test for water pH is right at the source, right away, using strips. And it looks like the results are between 5 and 6 pH. So that's very interesting. It actually, the pH was higher through Simple Lab, but with the test strips, it says between 5 and 6. Results of the pH strip are 4. So TAP score said 5.94, which is below their perfect range of 6.2 to 6.4. But this one actually says that it's even more acidic. So the pH strip says that it's 4, which is very interesting. So it dropped quite a bit. Hey friends, it's Jess and Jericho's leaving me, but you'll see him when I'm testing this water. So last month I tested 3 different types of water and compared it to my unfiltered city tap water to see what solution is the best. What kind of filter takes out all the nasty contaminants, but I also wanted to test the pH to see what is the perfect cat drinking water based on what cat water recommends. So my unfiltered tap water got a 7.4 pH. I tested that in January, and then last month I tested a stainless steel faucet filter, which got 7.43 pH, so it went up a little bit. My reverse osmosis filter got a 6.3 pH, so quite a bit down from the unfiltered tap. And cat water bottled water got a 5.94 pH, and this is actually lower than what they say is in the water. So they say that the perfect pH is between 6.2, 6.4. They say that theirs is within that range, but TAP Scores kit actually said that it was 5.94. Well, Simple Lab did tell me that the most accurate way to test for water pH is right at the source, right away, using strips. Now, I do understand that the pH might change in transit, but with the color strips, sometimes it's difficult to match up the color, but we'll see what it says when we do it. Now, of course, TAP Scores kits are excellent at testing for contaminants, but they are working on ways to kind of explain better the pH testing. So this is a brand new box with brand new test strips. As an affiliate, I did get these for free. It was actually Simple Lab's idea to make this follow-up video, so I really appreciate that. But I'm also able to give you a discount. So you can use code Caticles to save $10 on your first order of $100 or more. So what we need to do is fill a clean glass container with water from each source, wave the pH strip in the water for 10 seconds, shake it once to remove excess water, and then wait 20 seconds, and then use the pH color code on the back of this card. It says to complete the test within 10 seconds. So for the unfiltered tap water, I'm just going to take it straight from the faucet. And again, this was 7.4 initially with the Simple Lab test. And it looks like the results are between 5 and 6 pH. So that's very interesting. It actually, the pH was higher through Simple Lab, but with the test strips, it says between 5 and 6. That's what I mean. It's kind of difficult to tell with the colors, but I would say that it's somewhere between 5 and 6. For the stainless steel faucet filter, this is a 5-stage filtration system. It is not reverse osmosis, but it does claim to filter out contaminants. So this one did filter out the disinfection byproducts, but it did add some fluoride to the water. But it looks like the results here are between 5 and 6. So TAP score said 7.43, but the pH says 5 to 6. So I would say if you were looking for an ideal pH range, then this would probably be good compared to unfiltered tap, considering that it removes the disinfection byproducts. Unfortunately though, it does add fluoride to the water. It does say that it adds minerals, but you know, I mean, there was more fluoride in that water compared to my unfiltered tap water when I did these test kits. But that's why it's super important for you to test your water source. You can do well water, city water, and you can do bottled water. You can do rainwater. You can also test for specific analytes if you know that there's something specific in your water. And they have all of these test kits available along with the pH strips. So I'll link everything in the description below along with my code so you can save some money. So next we're gonna do cat water. This is a brand new bottle that I just bought at Petco. I wanna make sure that we're using a fresh sample, but I did still have the bottle that I used last month, and it looks like they changed the bottle. So the one that I used last month is completely clear. The one that I just bought is blue. So anyway, the results of the pH strip are 4. So TAP score said 5.94, which is below their perfect range of 6.2 to 6.4. But this one actually says that it's even more acidic. So the pH strip says that it's 4, which is very interesting. So it dropped quite a bit, considering that it says it's supposed to be 6.2 or 6.4 between that range. So I'm interested to know in the comments if you use cat water and you use pH strips. Let me know in the comments what your results are. Next, we're going to do the reverse osmosis filter. So I really like this one because it removes all of the contaminants, and there was only a little bit of barium, but it wasn't exceeding the health goals. So I'm going to make a fresh batch of water and immediately pour it into the clean glass and wave around the pH strip. And actually, I'm a bit disappointed. This one also looks like it's 4. So it's much more acidic, and it drops down from what was supposed to be the perfect range of 6.3. So I am a little disappointed in that, because I thought that it was perfect in that it removed all of the contaminants and also produced the perfect pH. But, you know, it does make sense that the pH changes with temperature changes and when it's exposed to air. And my brother, who works in water sanitation, says that if it's in a dark place, it can change. If it's exposed to the sun, it can change. And with the test kit, you bottle it up and put it in a dark box. The lab gets it the next day and tests it immediately. But in transit, it could change because of the temperature changes and because of the light changes. So it does make sense, but I am still going to use the reverse osmosis because it filters out the bromodichloromethane, the chloroform, the total THMs, and it removes the fluoride, removes all of the other heavy metals. So, I mean, yes, it's more acidic than it should be, but frankly, Jericho doesn't even drink water. He has a high moisture diet, so I'm not really concerned about that. He eats a species appropriate proper feline diet, so I'm not too concerned about his water being a little too acidic. But I would say if you're using cat water specifically for that pH and not relying on proper food, then I would say that that's concerning, considering that it's lower than what they say is the ideal range. So it is more acidic than what cats need. The other thing about cat water in those results is that it had a lot of antimony, which is a heavy metal, and it did exceed the health goals. So, you know, again, you would have to test your water. They do have plastic bottled water test kits. That's the one that I use for cat water and for the unfiltered tap, and for the reverse osmosis and the stainless steel faucet filter, I used city water test kit because I live in a city. But like I said, they do also have well water and rain water, and you can get that discount in the description. And if you do want to use the reverse osmosis filter that I use, there is a 10% off link in the description. If you go with the glass carafe model that I have, you'll get 10% off. Or you can buy their classic model that you'll get 10% off plus a free 1-year filter pack. So you basically get 18 months worth of filters, because the filter does come with one set of filters. You can check out this video right over meow to see the full report of unfiltered tap versus reverse osmosis, stainless steel, and cat water. You can see all the analytes that it tests for. Thank you so much for watching.